Unlock your dream property with Meeks Realty Group, where Rich the Realtor makes real estate dreams a reality. Whether it's residential or commercial, we've got Charleston to Huntington covered. Your key to exceptional real estate experiences start here. Meeks Realty Group. Contact us at meeks.us.
The views and opinions expressed on this program do not necessarily reflect the views and opinions of 580 WCHS, its employees, or WVRC Media. From the studios of WVRC Media, the country, the United States of America, the state, West Virginia, the city, Charleston. This is the Dave Allen Show on 580 Live. And your host.
What we've got here is failure to communicate.
He's kind of a big deal.
I have come here to chew bubblegum and kick ass, and I'm all out of bubblegum.
Dave Allen.
Hey, folks, good Monday morning to you. Welcome to the show. Ryan Nicholson is our producer today. Biggly Piggly Wiggly Hotline 304-345-5858. And the Tony the Tailor text 304-935-5008. Now, we do have a new text line sponsor. That's my good friend Tony the Tailor. I'm going to talk about that a little bit later on, but I'm going to go ahead and apologize now, Ryan, for the number of times I say Fruit Pharmacy text line, because I've been doing it, you know, for about 4 years now. So, but yeah, we do have a new text line sponsor. It is Tony the Tailor now. So I have to redo my card here. We come to you from the Parmar Store studio. If there's not a Parmar Store near you now, there will be soon. Stop in your local Parmar Store. Stock up on everything you're going to need for the 4th of July. And if you run out of something, don't worry. They will be open. And as always, if there's not a Parmar Store near you now, there will be soon. And we are sponsored by Thornhill Auto Group, including Thornhill Mitsubishi on the Thornhill Motor Mile, US 119 in Chapmanville. Make this summer the summer for you and your family to have a lot of fun in a new 2024 Mitsubishi Outlander or Outlander Plus. Plug-in hybrid. See them for all the details. 4th of July week, for many of you, a shortened work week. Many, not all. Programming note, I'm here today, tomorrow, and Wednesday. No shows on the 4th of July or on Friday. I will be back next Monday. Now, on the Today Show, Regatta kicks off. Charleston in 2 days. Charleston Mayor Amy Schuler Goodwin will join us to talk about that a little bit later on. Plus, the fallout continues from the presidential debate from Thursday night. I didn't get to all the text about that on the show Friday. I will open up that subject kind of in the middle of the show, around 9:25 or so, before we bring the mayor on. And as always, your calls and texts are welcome too. Now, as I said, we do have a new text line sponsor here for one of West Virginia's, well, actually, it's West Virginia's finest men's store. That's what they call themselves. Tony the Tailor on Virginia Street. Tony is a lifelong friend and a good dude. So I'm glad to have him on as part of the show. I got Andrea Garrett here, who is the state director for the West Virginia Faith and Freedom Coalition. Andrea, good morning. Welcome to the show.
Good morning, Dave. Thank you for having me.
And I apologize, in my preview, I said that Curtis Workman was coming. But Curtis is not here, but you are here. And that was miscommunication on my part.
That's quite all right. He would have done a better job.
Oh, no, yes, you'll be fine. You'll be fine. Now, explain to everyone what exactly is the West Virginia Faith and Freedom Coalition.
Sure. The West Virginia Faith and Freedom Coalition is about 2 years old. It was started in 2009 by Ralph Reed with the purpose of connecting communities of faith to the political process. And so, like I said, just 2 years ago, we started here in West Virginia. It exists in many other states. West Virginia is one of the newer chapters, but we're just a national grassroots movement made up of about 3 million members nationwide to mobilize and train people of faith for effective civil action.
So you recently had a conference, mm-hmm. a national conference. Talk about that.
We did. So that's the Road to Majority Conference, and the Faith and Freedom West Virginia chapter. We brought about 45 West Virginians who came along with us, and we enjoyed it. It was a fantastic event, first of all. A lot of folks of faith.
Where was it?
Leaders.
Where was it held?
It was at the Washington Hilton in D.C.
Okay.
There are some great speakers there, including the former president. We had several state governors, some governor candidates. We have members of Congress, senators, just a great group of people that spoke to us. It was fantastic.
Religion has been in the news a lot lately, mm-hmm. with the governor of Louisiana proposing that the Ten Commandments be posted in every classroom, and the governor of Oklahoma ordering the Bible to be taught in classrooms of public school. Controversial, to say the least. I think I already know the answer to this, Andrea, but where is your group on these things?
Yeah, of course. So we certainly support Christian values. Those are policies that we would support. In fact, the Faith and Freedom Coalition as a national group awarded the Winston Churchill Lifetime Achievement Award to Pastor John Hagee for his work with troubled youth, supporting Israel and other nationwide ministries. But of course, we support all the biblical influences and those values as often as we can.
I noticed, Andrea, that former President Trump was one of the speakers at your conference. You just mentioned that. And I'm not trying to be argumentative here, but I feel the need to ask the question. And so please hear me out on this. Does the former president's, shall we say, some of his ideals or action, it's been said by a lot of people that maybe they fly directly in opposition to what most Christians believe or how they live their lives. I mean, you know, folks obviously are not the spokesperson for every Christian in America. I get that. But lots of people, including myself, I guess, kind of have a little bit of an issue with how Christians can align with the former president. Again, not trying to start an argument here, just for the sake of discussion. How would you address that?
It's a good question, Dave, and certainly worth asking. Especially within some of the recent things that have come to light, I could see why a lot of Christians would start to question that. But for us, we're really focusing on policy, and this is really a fight of good and evil. And so what we have seen and continue to focus on is the fact that Trump has championed issues that are important to faith and freedom. So, for example, defending all of those traditional values that fall under the, like, examples would be Roe versus Wade, defending Israel. We need someone to continue to protect those values, and he has the proven track record of doing it between the two candidates.
And I've heard a lot of people that have echoed that same sentiment that you were saying, that they may not totally be in love with the guy.
That's correct.
But they think it's policy. It's more policy than anything else.
It's all about policy. And again, that's our focus. We're educating Christian voters, and to us, that has to be our focus.
Talking to with Andrea Garrett again, who is the state director for the West Virginia Faith and Freedom Coalition. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live is brought to you in part by Live Healthy West Virginia, presented by WVU Medicine. Live Healthy tackles pressing health issues, heart disease, diabetes, Alzheimer's, and RSV. It's a podcast offering insights into medical breakthroughs and preventative care, featuring WVU Medicine's expert physicians aimed at fostering healthier lifestyles in and beyond West Virginia. It is a valuable resource for all. Discover the latest episodes on WVMetroNews.com under the podcast menu and start your journey towards better health today. I want to talk about some of the state races, and not looking for endorsements or anything like that. Some of the state election races. A lot of people don't think that they'll be too competitive, talking about the race for governor between Attorney General Patrick Morrissey and Democrat nominee Steve Williams of Huntington, the battle for Senate between Governor Justice and Wheeling Mayor Glenn Elliott, who is the Democratic nominee for that seat that's currently held by Joe Manchin. Will you folks be involved in any of these races? Or
we do plan to be involved in the extent of providing a voter guide. And so these will showcase some of the different platforms that all these candidates are standing on, and some of the ones with a track, you know, any kind of history. We will be showcasing some of the policies that they've been in support of, any bills that they have sponsored, that kind of thing. But I should say too that as a national organization, we have a budget of around $60 million that will be used to knock close to 10 million doors of Christian conservative voters. We have. We're prepared to make 10 million phone calls, 25 million text messages, and distribute 30 million Faith and Freedom voter guides. And in West Virginia, we plan to do around 200,000 of those.
That's a lot of door knocking and a lot of texting, a lot of calls. You don't have to do all of it, do you?
Not me personally, no.
It's and these voter guides, are they, I mean, you're going to just make them available online? It's an actual hard copy that you're going to take to people's homes or mm-hmm. both? Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, both. And in fact, we will be deliberating over some of the specifics of the voter guide. And we have a board meeting later this month. So we'll discuss how that's going to be dispersed across the state. But we're actually looking for paid voter education reps to distribute these voter guides. Oh. So if anybody's interested.
So you're hiring. Is that what you're saying? and where can people learn more about that if they're interested in going to work for you?
Thank you. So we have a website, which is wvfaithandfreedom.com.
All right. I'm going to give you like the final, like I do with my political figures, Andrea, I'm going to give you like the final 30 to just say anything that you'd like to about your organization.
Yeah. Well, thank you. So the Faith and Freedom Coalition's goal is to protect time-honored values, individual liberties, and stronger families. And so if that's something that aligns with you and you'd like to help join the effort of helping educate Christian voters and help engage and mobilize these voters in our community, please feel free to reach out and be part of our organization. We are always looking for folks to help further our mission.
And you got a lot of, as I said, your organization's got a lot of door knocking to do between now.
We have our work cut out for us. Yes.
I've heard people say, and maybe this is a little bit of hyperbole or whatever, but I have heard people say that this, and I'm 53 years old, this may be the most important election of mm-hmm. Of their lifetime, no matter, you know, other people said that. Do you feel that way too?
I do feel that way. I think as far
but you're not 53. But
I'm not 53.
But go ahead.
But I do feel that as far as the trajectory of the United States is concerned, this is a pivotal election. And in fact, it is the goal of the West Virginia and the National Faith and Freedom Organization to help support the largest turnout of Christian votes in U.S. history. And we're on track to do that.
All right. Andrea, again, give us the website and the contact information.
Sure. wvfaithandfreedom.com.
All right. Well, good luck with everything. We'll have to have you folks back on before the election. I appreciate you being here. Thanks
a lot.
Thank
you, Dave.
All right. It is 9:18. Hang out with me 1 second here. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live, presented in part by General Hardware of Winfield and Milton and General Lumber of Winfield. For all projects, big and small, shop locally. Visit General Hardware, WV.com. Biggly Piggly Wiggly Hotline, 304-345-5858. Tony the Tailor text, 304-935-5008. Charleston Mayor Amy Schuler Goodwin coming up a little bit later on to talk about Regatta, plus some other things in the news in Charleston we'll talk to her about. And we're going to get a little debate talk, not with the mayor, but with myself and you, coming up right after this. We're back after this on The Voice of Charleston, WCHS.
Brought to you by the Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses. Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses bring first-class businesses to your community.
Make this summer the summer in a new 2024 Mitsubishi Outlander or Outlander plug-in hybrid. With its premium interior, 2 years limited maintenance included, and an industry-leading warranty. Drive home today starting at $28,395. The moment is now at Thornhill Mitsubishi. Super Hall controls and available feature on all trim levels. Manufacturer suggested retail price. Excludes destination handling, tax, title, license, dealer charges, and options. All supplies last. Limited availability. Participating dealers may require placing an order and could cause a delay in delivery. Retailer price, terms, and vehicle availability may vary. See your local Mitsubishi retailer for details.
Welcome to Poca Valley, where we've been in business since 1908. Today, we serve Roane, Kanawha, Putnam, and surrounding counties. We believe you deserve banking that provides friendly customer service. For all of your financial needs, stop by one of our 8 convenient locations. Call us at 844-782-2651 or visit us online at PocaValleyBank.com. Poca Valley, where relationships matter.
Member FDIC.
Biggly Piggly Wiggly on Spring Street has served 3 generations of shoppers since 1955 as the largest locally owned independent grocery store in the area. The Joseph family owners grew up here, so you know they're invested in the community. They provide the biggest variety of choice meats, the freshest produce, an in-house deli bakery, great wine selection, and more of your favorite brands. Every purchase gives you gasoline points so you can save at our pumps. Order online for pickup at BigglyPigglyWiggly.com. Biggly Piggly Wiggly on Spring Street. No one beats the pig.
It is 9:20. Ryan Nicholson is our producer today. In the heart of West Virginia, there exists a profound force that goes beyond the realm of sports, transcending limitations and fostering a sense of belonging. Talking about Special Olympics, a remarkable initiative showcase of the latest episode of West Virginia Enriched in collaboration with Huntington, stands as a testament to the power of determination, unity, and unwavering support. See a video highlighting the Special Olympics at Facebook.com/580WCHS. Biggly Piggly Wiggly Hotline, 304-345-5858. Tony the Tailor text, 304-935-5008. The Dave Allen Show and 580 Live is brought to you in part by Morgan & Morgan, America's largest injury law firm. All right, let's get to some text this morning. Texas, your guest lost me when she put Trump and Christian values in the same discussion. Christians believe in love for all. Don't confuse true Christians with Christian nationalists, says a texter. Texter says, why do Christians have to force their religion on people via the government? Why do Christians try to violate the Constitution? Text says, the Faith and Freedom Coalition is a good organization. I am happy to support them and all the good work they have been doing, says a texter. Texter says, I'm all for Christians to promote their faith in the political realm. Just start rendering unto Caesar that which is Caesar's and pay taxes on your income. Corporations are people, but churches are churches, says a texter. Texter says, how can Christians align themselves with Trump? Really? After crystal clear evidence, after the Holocaust on October 8th, targeting students on college campuses, chants up from the river to the sea, intimidations on New York trains, etc. The question must be, how can any Jewish person be aligned with the Democrat Party today? I want to welcome aboard another new sponsor to the show. All kinds of changes, new stuff coming on here. The folks at Jute. What is Jute? J-O-O-T, you ask. Well, Jute is a pretty elite security company located here in the Valley, actually in other locations as well, but they're based in Taze Valley. I had Josh Beam from Jute on the show last week. Good folks, so if you're in need of a security system, state-of-the-art type stuff for your home or business, get with them. Their website is protectedbyjute.com, protectedbyjute.com, J-O-O-T. Coming up on tomorrow's show, we're going to talk with Jared Page. He's an up-and-comer in the world of politics here in Kanawha County, and he's very involved in a lot of things in St. Albans, particularly in city government in St. Albans. He's lined up and ready to go on the show tomorrow. Brad McElhenney is also going to be on the show tomorrow, and we'll continue talking more things with the regatta as we get closer and closer to the regatta, which begins really around noon on Wednesday. And again, the mayor is going to join us to talk about that a little bit later on. And as always, we talk about other things with the mayor, too. So if you got a question or comment, you're welcome to call us up when the mayor's on the show about 10, 15 minutes or so from now. Bigly Piggly Wiggly Hotline, 304-345-5858. Tony the Tailor text, 304-935-5008. Text says, Matthew 7:15, beware of false prophets who come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ravenous wolves, says a texter. So I watched a lot of the coverage on the Sunday morning shows yesterday about the debate Thursday night between former President Donald Trump and current President Joe Biden. I also heard State Democratic Party Chair Mike Pushkin comments on he was on Hoppy on Friday. I will say this, at least most Democrats are admitting that Biden had a horrible performance on Thursday night. I would like a little honesty from a lot of them, though. Maybe saying the president performed horribly without bringing up Donald Trump. Now, did Trump lie about a lot? Yes, he did. But we all knew that going in. That's just Donald Trump. That's who Donald Trump is. And we all know, no one asked me, but I think that before going after Trump, and again, you're not speaking to a Donald Trump fan here, you know, you know that by now. I think maybe the Democrats need to clean up their own collective backyards and figure out what they are going to do about President Joe Biden. If Biden were your grandfather, you probably would not let him live alone or drive a car, period. It would be time to take the keys. Now, I will say I did see some clips of him Friday at a campaign event, and he did look and sound better at that particular event. But for me, I think the damage is already done. As they say, you cannot put the ketchup back in the bottle, toothpaste in the tube, whatever analogy you want to use. It is one thing to have a bad debate. In the world of politics, it happens all the time. Outside politics, it happens. Most people would probably say that Dr. Martin Luther King was one of the greatest speakers in the history of America. Do you think he knocked it out of the park every time? Of course not. I heard a comment from Raphael Warnock out of Georgia on the news this morning when he was saying, look, I'm a pastor and all my sermons weren't exactly, all-star. It happens. People have bad nights. But in my opinion, this goes well beyond that. And please don't give me this, he had a cold thing, and he suffered from speech impediments. I mean, he's done that his entire life, had the speech impediment, I mean. This performance on Thursday night, in my opinion, was beyond that of a cold or a stutter or two. He was totally lost out there. And I think at this point, I mean, let's face it, most folks, I think, have already decided who they're going to vote for. I mean, if you are in the Trump camp, you are 100% in the Trump camp. And I don't think anything is going to change that. I mean, the indictments, all this other, all it's done for Trump is make his poll numbers go up. And his conviction in the case has made his fundraising go through the roof. And so if you are somebody who is undecided, and quite frankly, I don't think there's a lot of people that are undecided out there at this point. But for those who are undecided as to who they are going to vote for, did anything that you saw on Thursday night from Joe Biden, did you get anything at all out there to give you the confidence to vote for him in November? I mean, simply put, my opinion here only, if the Democrats have any shot of winning in November, of remaining in the White House, Joe Biden's got to step aside. Period. I mean, it's got to happen. And again, this is not about Donald Trump for me. This is about President Biden. He's got to step aside. And there is, and again, I've been doing a little bit of reading on this. I'm certainly not the expert on it, but there is a path that could very well happen. All he's got to do is basically just say, I'm pulling out. I mean, it's an open convention. Keep in mind, this was one of the, if not the earliest presidential debate of all time. So well before the convention, that's almost unheard of for the Republicans or the Democrats. But he could do that, and the family could do that. And again, I'm not speaking this is not partisan on my part. Because my feelings, you've listened to the show, my feelings on Donald Trump. He's got to step aside, in my opinion. He has to. That got some text. let me get to the text here. Text says, so many people are calling for Biden to drop out. Why isn't anyone calling for Trump to drop out? I am, texter. I am. I was from day one. He is less qualified and just as old. I agree. Let me say about the age thing. We all know people in our lives that are as spry as they can possibly be at 90 years old. And we know people who are, like me, old and decrepit when they're in their 30s. So I don't know that you can compare the ages. There's, a 3 to 4 year age difference, I think, between Biden. But I mean, based on just the performance the other night. Now, again, put all Trump's lies aside, okay? I'm talking about just the strength of the performance the other night. And the polls have showed this, no matter what poll it was, that Donald Trump won that the other night. I mean, hands down. Based on, not based on content necessarily, but based just on performance. Texas, speaking of Martin Luther King Jr., it is well documented he was a womanizer and had multiple affairs. Just saying, we need to keep some perspective when we throw stones. Let's throw them fairly. Those rumors have been there, and you don't even want to talk about the morals of John Kennedy, okay, or FDR, for that matter. So the only difference is now there's a whole lot more coverage of them, I think. I mean, remember, FDR, if you follow this story, you know, if you've done any reading on this, the press corps would not show for a long time FDR in a wheelchair because they didn't want to show weakness. Yeah. Don't think that would be the case now. Okay, that's a question for the mayor. Which I appreciate. We'll get to those later. Tex, so before you go on your Biden rant about people protecting him or deluding themselves to his abilities, Trump supporters have been doing that for years. Biden supporters pretend he's not a doddering dummy. Trump supporters pretend he is not an immoral black hole beholden to those who tribute and enrichment schemes best suit him, looking to remake America in his dog-humping leg image. Texas, for some reason, you seem to think Dems pretending is worse than GOP pretending, defaulting to you excusing Trump. A brain-dead Biden is not a threat to the free democracy. It's where we are. And I will say this. If we thought we were interested, and I haven't seen any ratings on the debate Thursday night, but I'm sure they were through the roof. Other countries were watching it, too. Other countries were very, very interested in what was going on Thursday night. Tex said, always one-sided for Republicans. Democrats must be honest and tell the truth. Democrats have to clean up their house, according to Day, the self-appointed Pope of Democrats. Self-appointed Pope of Democrats, Ryan. Meanwhile, Republicans can run a sex abuser who partied with Jeffrey Epstein while knowing he likes them young and 100% supports the attack on the Capitol. Clean up all this, Republicans, and then we will listen to your advice, says a texter. Texter says, Dave, we all know who is the driving force behind keeping Joe in the race. It's Jill. She loves the power his being president brings with it, and she is not willing to just roll over and give it up. She is Edith Wilson reincarnate. All that's left for her to do is to hold his hand in hers and help him sign legislation, says a texter. Texter says, Dave, during Trump's term, the media pushed for the 25th Amendment to be invoked over 600 times, and all the media's reactions to Joe Biden's debate performance last night, they have yet to do the same in regards to him. Tex says, I didn't have sex with a porn star. Stop apologizing for the felon rapist liar. 90 minutes doesn't wipe out 50 years of service. Was simply a bad night, says a texter. Texter says, that debate was the first game of the season. Got 4 months left. Tex says, where's Joe Manchin when you need him? okay, read that one. All right. Who could use 500 gallons of free gas? The stations of WVRC Media, Charleston, and Parmar stores back with a great gas giveaway. Someone's going to win 500 gallons of free gasoline. You can register at any Kanawha County Parmar location or at A to Z Outlet of St. Albans, Trojan Landing Marine of Charleston, Pearson Legal Services of Kanawha City, the Milton Flea Market, Quantum Sports at Hurricane in Charleston, Halfway Market in Milton, Pew Furniture in Charleston, East Coast Tees in Nitro, Shuckers of St. Albans, and Tractor Pros in St. Albans. We're going to draw the winner July 27th during our special event at A to Z Outlet in St. Albans. Starting at 10 a.m. The Great Gas Giveaway is presented by WVRC Media of Charleston and Parmar stores. If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon. Tex says, dog humping leg. Can we make that into a promo soundbite? Ryan, that's on you. Tex says, I thought the early debate was a great idea. Now we all know he's not capable. I really thought his family would step up and tell him to step away. Sad they haven't, says a texter. Tech says almost half the audience of the 2020 first debate. All right, appreciate that. While the network's biggest TV audience of the year, the count of those who watched Thursday night debate on TV marks a 30% decline from 2020, when more than 73 million people watched the first debate between Biden and Trump across all TV networks. In 2016, a record 84 million people watched the first debate between Hillary Clinton and Trump. And I appreciate the texture for putting that out there. But also, you have to consider that how many people were streaming it, watching it online. You know, we had a guy, somebody called Talkline that said they listened to it on the radio. That's a little old school. We appreciate that, though. We had coverage here on our station. Texas, speaking of liar, Brandon has been a liar for 50 years. As a texter. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live is brought to you in part by Husson's Pizza. This month it's your favorite Husson's. You can order any regular price large 1-inch pizza and get a 2-liter of Pepsi at no additional charge. We're going to take a break. We are going to talk to Charleston Mayor Amy Schuler Goodman when we come back after this on The Voice of Charleston, WCHS.
Jatar Family Businesses. Eric Jatar Family Businesses want to thank you for shopping locally.
Are you changing jobs or gearing up for retirement? Don't navigate your financial journey alone. At Fourth Avenue Financial, we specialize in guiding individuals through life's transitions. From optimizing your retirement savings to managing your investments, we're here to provide expert advice every step of the way. Schedule your free consultation with John Burdett and take control of your financial future today. 4thAvenueFinancial.com.
Securities offered through Jenny B. Cole Financial Incorporated. Member FINRA SIPC. Advisory services offered through Jenny B. Cole Advisors Incorporated.
Summer is here, and if you're looking to replace that old worn-out car with a reliable and stylish ride without breaking the bank, then you need to get over to Walker Chevrolet in Nitro. Walker Chevrolet is stocked right now with inventory, both new and used, and they have the car, truck, or SUV that you've been looking for. And you know that you're going to get the best deal possible at Walker because Gene and Ryan built their business the old-fashioned way by making friends. There are no gimmicks or games here, just honest, fair deals. And if you have a car that you want to get rid of, don't forget Swacker Chevrolet is still buying cars too. Yeah, that's right. All makes and models are welcome at Walker, and they're going to give you top dollar for it, even if you plan to buy somewhere else. This summer, the car and the deal that you've been waiting for is waiting for you right now at Walker Chevrolet in the shadow of the Interstate Bridge, just off the Nitro exit of I-64. Walker Chevrolet, making friends one deal at a time.
I want to learn how to cook, but I keep ordering takeout.
Accomplishing goals is hard, but when your goal is to learn a new language, Babbel makes it easy. In just 15 minutes a day, Babbel will help you start having conversations in as little as 3 weeks. Words and phrases you'll actually use. So when someone asks,
"How's your French going?"
you can say,
"Babbel facilite grandement l'apprentissage d'une nouvelle langue."
Now try Babbel for free at Babbel.com. That's Babbel.com. Babbel.com.
We got 21 minutes away from 10. Bigly, Piggly, Wiggly Hotline, 304-345-5858. Tony the Taylor text 304-935-5008. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live is brought to you part by Bridge Valley. Are you interested in improving your company's IT workforce? You may want to know Bridge Valley offers custom-tailored IT training to bridge the skills gap. At Bridge Valley, train for little or no cost. With a 50-50 salary match, Bridge Valley can also supply skilled graduates and apprenticeships for your company. Visit bridgevalley.edu/apprenticeships for more information. Charleston Mayor Amy Goodwin will be coming up here momentarily. I believe I see the mayor. I got a couple. Calm down there. I've got to catch a breath. I got a couple texts I got to get to here. Text says, after Biden's performance Thursday night, it is clear now as to why the Democrats are so determined to not release the audio of the Her interview so the public can hear his voice, says a texter. I got a gift here. A little housekeeping here. A big announcement came out Friday afternoon that we here at WVRC Media Charleston are pretty happy about. Two of our own, Jeff Jenkins and Woody Woods, are going into the West Virginia Broadcasting Hall of Fame, honoring television and radio broadcasters, are going to be inducted at a ceremony in October in Huntington. They'll join a long, long list of broadcasters from this building and the company as a whole. This is not the entire list, but just from this company here. I mean, you know, WBRC Media Charleston. Stephen Jennings from V100, Chris Lawrence, Fred Persinger, Joe Parsons, Hoppy Kirchwell, Tony Caridi out of Morgantown, the late Don Cook, the late Paul Howard, just to name a few, and there are plenty, plenty more. What can you say about Jeff Jenkins and Woody Woods? I mean, two of the best people, forget on-air staff, just two of the best people you will ever, ever know. And I will say, had I never darkened the doorways here at 1111, I would have been honored just to know Woody Woods and Jeff Jenkins, which I've known both of them for a number of years. Couldn't be more proud of my teammates, so congratulations to Jeff Jenkins and Woody Woods. They are going to the Hall of Fame.
Well deserved.
Hall of Fame for mayors. Amy Schuller, a good one.
How are you? Hi. Sorry, I was running. I was running.
Sorry. We've got, because you were, well, here's the thing. And I looked out there and I saw you were with Steve Animal. I said, oh, no, this
oh,
is
no,
not good.
It wasn't. It this actually not was good. Not good. I will confirm it was not.
I got
good.
A nice little Sternwell Regatta mug.
Yeah,
here, thank
here
you very
we go.
Much.
It's called a silly pint.
A silly pint?
That's what it's called. Oh. It's a glass that doesn't sweat. Don't ask me.
Okay.
Unlike me, sweating.
I got you. Well, you can calm down a little bit now.
Busy week.
I got some things in the news I want to get to
please.
And we'll talk to you about. And plus, you got text waiting on you,
wonderful.
Too. So we're, as I said, we're just 48 hours away from bringing a couple 100,000 people into the capital city. But I want to talk, let's start on a positive. Let's talk about this Capital Connector.
Oh, thanks. Yeah. So many moons ago, 5.5 years ago, when I got into office, you know, I stood stacked on the floor, lots of plans, right? Plans to develop the riverfront, plans to do more bike lanes, walk lanes. And we said, now let's put it into action. And so we went after some federal funding. And simply because of our relationship and the good work of Senator Shelley Moore Capito and Senator Joe Manchin, both of them came to bat for us and said, yes, we're going to give you a $1.75 million RAISE grant, the only grant 2 years ago, well, almost 3 years ago now, in the state of West Virginia. We received that. We've been planning. And last week we announced we have now a $25 million construction grant, all federal funds that are coming to the city of Charleston from Magic Island to the 35th Street Bridge to make the riverfront what it should be, a bikeable, walkable play place, lots of lights, and to use our riverfront as we have needed to use it. We're a river city that doesn't use our riverfront. Now we're going to.
And I think I heard this morning there's going to be a public meeting in August,
I think it's
okay. We'll publicize it a lot between now and then. I think they had it on the morning news this morning. So to get the public's input, because this is important as well.
Yeah, and the first public input session we had is monumental. By the way, it's online as well. But our first meeting was in that huge big conference room. I know you've been over at the public library. Mm-hmm. That big, beautiful public meeting room was packed with people. What do you want to see? This isn't an Amy Goodwin project. This is a City of Charleston project. I want what you want. And so the input has been really, really great.
Tonight, Mayor, there is city council meeting tonight, and it was reported over the weekend on our news and mm-hmm. also in the Gazette that City Councilman Joe Solomon is proposing some sort of a resolution as it pertains to the police, I guess, not arresting, as he calls them, the unhoused during Regatta. You want to address that?
I have not received any emails or phone calls from that council member, so I really can't speak to it in so much as just to say that I did read it. And my only comment would be that our 9-member care team every day with the Charleston Police Department, with the fire department, all of our city social service agencies, Kanawha Valley Collective, United Way, so many, are going to continue to work with those in our community who need assistance and get them into services. By the way, we do that every single second of every single day. We do that. But what I will not do is tell the police, which, by the way, city council can't tell the police not to do their jobs. But you just can't do it, Dave.
Right, right.
And I'm not going to support that, not for one single second. Most of the council members who have called me concerned or confused about it, because there's been very little outreach on this, very little communication, is I don't get it. I don't understand it. It seems borderline unconstitutional. And I'm not telling the police department or the municipal judge what to do. We can't do that, by the way. And the majority of the comments that I've heard back is our care team does an incredible job. They just simply do. We are a very compassionate administration. We take care of folks who need help. But if somebody has a warrant out for their arrest, you will be arrested. That's what the police do. And oh, by the way, you want me to do that. You want our police officers to do their job. By the way, they're very compassionate. Our police work so hard, Dave, day in and day out. I know you know this. You support our police and they adore you. But don't tell them not to do their job. You know, I listened to the story of one of our members of our care team, our director, tell me that a couple weeks ago, they were working with this guy who was having a super bad day. And one of our police officers spent an hour and a half, 2 hours looking for a size 12 shoe for this guy. So don't tell me that our police are not compassionate people. They are. But they're going to do their job. But they also have compassion. And that's what I think people need to know about our police department.
Mayor, is there any truth to what was alleged that when the regatta got back that there was an extra effort to keep the unhoused, the homeless, whatever you want to call them, away from the regatta?
5.5 years ago, when I got here into office, we put in a plan, you know, and I'm sorry to say, ripping up benches and ignoring the project and vilifying people on Facebook does about a big goose egg, does this much to help people. We need to take care of people. And oh, by the way, there are consequences when you break the law. And so do you want me to only enforce the law during certain times? And you're going to ask me not to enforce the law during regatta week? Well, we can't do that. That's not what the people have elected us to do. We're going to be compassionate. We're going to help people. But we're also going to hold people accountable. Our citizens require us to do that, and we're going to continue to do it. So, no, I think it was just a moment for maybe somebody to get into the newspaper, to be quite honest with you.
Tex says, what is the refuse schedule for the rest of the week in Charleston?
I asked that last night of Tina. It remains the same.
Remains the same?
It remains. Yeah, it remains.
Okay. Tex says, this is for the mayor, a drug house at 57th and Virginia in Kanawha City. Shooting there 3 weeks ago, dozens of different drug users in and out of the house, out-of-state cars parked along the residence, submit videos of people stumbling around out of the house and onto surrounding properties, passing out. Why is this place not busted, patrolled, harassed, or to make it not worth ruining the private lives of residents in that area? And again, Mayor, they're talking about 57th and Virginia in Kanawha City.
So I promise you that Andrew in my office is listening to this radio show. He's going to write it down. If you'd like to call me, 348-8174, 348-8174. We're happy to follow up with you directly, and I will follow up with Andrew when I get back to my office.
Texas, please ask the mayor about the McCorkle side of the river so that the city can be seen when driving on McCorkle Avenue.
Oh, yes. I bet you I know who that text is from. Yes. Working with the Army Corps of Engineers in the state of West Virginia, no, McCorkle is not ours. So,
okay. One other thing, and we're going to talk regatta.
Yeah,
I promise.
Hit me. That's fine.
Okay, hold on. I don't know how much you can say about this, but in the time that you have been on, former police chief Ty Kuntz, since the last time you were on, has been granted his disability. I know you're very limited in what you can say, but I will give you the opportunity to comment if you can.
Yeah, absolutely. This is what I will say. Boy, it's been a really long year. It's been a troubling year. But I will say this with confidence. I have the utmost confidence in our chief of police, Scott Dempsey, and our deputy chief of police, Jason Webb. The pension board, as I always know that they do, they take all of the information in front of them and make the best decision with the information that they have. And so from investigation to the pension board meeting, I feel very confident with the actions of our chief of police and our deputy chief of police and members of the pension board, Dave.
10 minutes away from 10, Tex says, Mayor, Saturday marked 4 years since you stole.
What did I steal?
You stole the Kanawha Rifleman plaque off the monument. When will it be restored so we can show inclusiveness to all of us? Where can we view it in person? In the meantime, it would be great if we could see it at Regatta.
Huh. Well, I don't have any plans to do that at Regatta, and I'm certainly happy to speak to whomever the texter is, 348-8174. You can call my office.
All right, let's get into some Regatta talk when we come back from the break. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live is brought to you in part by Pinnacle Consultants. Poor indoor air quality can cause a variety of health issues, allergies, respiratory problems, and more. Pinnacle Consultants offers specialized indoor air quality services for residential, commercial, and industrial-type settings. Visit PinnacleCorp.net because what you don't know can hurt you. Back after this on the Voice of Charleston, WCHS.
Jatar Family Businesses. Eric Jatar Family Businesses live to make life better for you and your family.
Looking to buy or sell U.S. coins or currency, or need an appraisal on a coin collection? The Coin Man in St. Albans has been established since 2009, and he's the area's expert in currency. Whether you're buying or selling coins and coin accessories, he's got you covered. But that's not all. He also deals in select antiques and glassware. Visit the Coin Man today at 2412 Kanawha Terrace in St. Albans and discover treasures that transcend time. The Coin Man, where every coin tells a story.
Satisfy your sweet tooth at Batter and Bliss Bakery this week's 50-50 Friday. With a menu that changes every day, you'll never tire of the fabulous options Batter and Bliss offers. From delicious pepperoni rolls to their signature molly dogs and custom cakes with the best homemade buttercream around. Open Tuesday through Saturday, located at 3448 Piedmont Road in Charleston. Friday at 9 a.m., go to WCHSnetwork.com and click the 50-50 Friday button to get 50% off gift certificates for Batter and Bliss Bakery, courtesy of the WCHS family of networks.
Do you have over $10,000 in credit card debt? If you're feeling the financial impact with unprecedented economic challenges, DebtBlue is here for you. With DebtBlue's success guarantee, you pay nothing unless your debt is reduced or completely resolved.
I'm just living sky high right now. I'm very thankful for it, and the team at DebtBlue are phenomenal. They're able to work with you. They're great.
Call for your free debt resolution information now. 800-200-6895. 800-200-6895.
Do you hear that? Asthma triggers are everywhere, from dust mites, pet dander, and pollen, to smog and smoke. An asthma attack can strike anywhere, anytime. Be prepared with quick-acting Primatene Mist. Clinically proven to open airways quickly. It's the number one FDA-approved asthma inhaler available over-the-counter. Primatene Mist. Breathe easy again. Use as directed.
Seven away from 10, the Dave Allen Show on 580 Live, brought to you part by your hometown baseball team, the Charleston Dirty Birds. Birds are off tonight. They'll begin a three-game road series tomorrow night in Long Island. They'll be back at Gomart Ballpark for a weekend series against Southern Maryland. For tickets, schedules, promotions, merchandise, and more, visit DirtyBirdsBaseball.com. Dave Wilson in the big chair for Hoppy this week. Campus Carry is now a thing. Dave will talk to WVU Dean of Students Corey Ferris about that and more. Talk Line with Dave Wilson in for Hoppy this week, coming up at 10:06. The mayor is here. Let's talk Regatta. We finally got to it. Let's talk
really
Regatta.
Let's talk it.
Regatta. So everything, I've got my nice little schedule over here. So everything kicks off with the vendors Wednesday at noon. But you've also got activities going on, not only overall, but also City Center at Slack Plaza with a lot of things going on there. I'll just let you take it from here. Go ahead.
Yeah, sure. So we start on Wednesday. We've got the wheel wash. That's going to be at City Center at Slack Plaza. A couple of things that you're going to see. That are going to be a little bit more convenient. Not only is the wheel wash going to be in City Center and Select Plaza, we're also going to have the Kids Fun Zone there as well. And, you know, the Kids Fun Zone, it used to be at Magic Island. And, you know, the feedback, which is, by the way, big into feedback, tell me what you want. A lot of parents saying, Amy, do you know how, you know, your boys are older, but you know how hard it is to have a double jog stroller, somebody on this hip, to go from Magic Island all the way down the boulevard? We hear you. We got you. Everything's going to be for the kids at City Center at Slack Plaza. On Wednesday, we've got Shaggy, which everybody is just talking about this ad nauseum. So I really feel like Shaggy's going to be a big night. That's right after the wheel wash. On Thursday, we've got not only fireworks, but we've got the premier Beatle band, three costume changes. These guys are... They're it.
Going through the different phases of their career, Sergeant Pepper to the...
Right. Yeah. These guys are it. On Friday, it's going to be an awesome country night, Montgomery Gentry. And then Saturday, I have already started on the Alexa at Home Apple Music. My boys who are home from school are like, Mom, you're such a geek. I love the 90s, Tone Loc, Vanilla Ice, all of the
Young MC.
Young MC, yeah. Naughty by Nature. So it's going to be super fun on Saturday, keeping in mind we've got the carnival going on. Keep in mind we've got all of the amazing vendors on Saturday. Gosh, what a big fire parade, 5 o'clock on Friday. Everybody loves the fire parade. For the past 2 years, Dave, there have been these two little boys who sit there on the west side, the beginning of the fire parade, mm-hmm. and they're going crazy when it starts. And so after last year, I went to their mom and said, would they like to start the fire parade with me and be in the parade?
Oh, how cool is that?
She said, and they're about this tall. She said, oh, my God, please don't mention it to them publicly until we get closer to the regatta, or I will never hear the end of it. So they're going to join me in the bucket truck on Friday at 5.
And you hope they're not listening this morning.
No, my gosh. Oh, yeah, I didn't think about that. Anyway, and then on
I'm not big among,
yeah,
you know, the,
right, the small people.
The children's.
Yeah, the children's. So, and then on Saturday, another fun thing. This is all for the kids. Yes, we have the wiener dog races. That's so fun at Magic Island. The funeral parade. A physician in town said to me, Amy, I'm so angry with you. The funeral parade last year made us late for our beach vacation. I said, oh, my gosh, was it the traffic? He said, no, it was my daughter who said, I want to be in the parade. We said, no, we're leaving for vacation then. We're not. So he said, we compromised with her. She's going to be able to be in the parade this year. And I said, oh, she'll lead it with me. And so we have our costumes already organized, ready to lead the funeral parade. And right after the funeral parade, we go right into Slamboree, which the wrestling thing last year was just, I mean, it was packed. I didn't realize, and this is a new thing that we started last year with Adam Harris and Matthew Sutton and Tim Brady and so many other wonderful folks. It's such a neat addition to what we've done with the regatta. So super fun. A crazy, crazy 4 days, which is the reason why I don't have my hair dried this morning, Dave.
Couple of quick texts here, not related to regatta. Text says, with the worst time of stray cats and dogs we've ever seen, would it be possible for the city to speak with veterinarians and ask them if they'd be willing to volunteer their time, rescue groups to trap strays, and use the Civic Center to do a large-scale spay and neuter operation? That would make a huge dent in the problem.
Sure, I can always ask, no doubt.
Tech says, why aren't all day passes available for the carnival rides after 5? This seems to be a time that all day passes would be most appropriate.
I don't know. I'll ask. I actually don't know.
I
don't know.
There you go. So you campaign on bringing regatta back.
I did. It was one of the things.
And when this
because I walked to 11,219 doors. Right. No, I did.
I know you did.
11,219 doors all by myself. And I will say this. It was a consistent theme, but we didn't just bring it back because Amy thought it was a great idea. Yes, I missed it, and I thought it was a great idea, but everybody else wanted me to.
Yeah.
And so what we said was, and I said year one, and I know I said it on this show, we'll bring it back and we're going to see. We're going to see how it goes. I'm a big believer in the year of three. This is year three.
This is year three. That's the most important.
Was it the right time? Is it the right location or the right acts? What's the mixture look like? Because we throw a lot of things at the wall. Some stick, some don't. This is sticking. I mean, this is really sticking. We've made adjustments that nobody else would see because it's mainly operations. Mm-hmm. When you host a party for 250,000 people, there's an ebb and flow to how you run things, where you park things, how you set up things. And so nobody would notice the changes that we've made, but we're getting better at it. We can't do the Charleston Sternwheel Regatta without our sponsors, especially in COVID. God bless Encova. They're just amazing. Moses, our hospitals, great, great folks, and our Charleston Sternwheel Regatta Board of Directors. It's a full-time job, and the regatta wouldn't happen without one person, mm-hmm. and her name is Jane.
Jane Bostic, yeah.
It's just that simple. It doesn't happen without Jane. She's the heart of the regatta.
All right, Mayor, we got to go. I appreciate you being here on the show.
Enjoy regatta.
This is probably the only time in the next couple of days you're going to be sitting down.
Yeah, so, this is it. So, I'm going to get my steps in, man.
So enjoy it. We've had you all over the building today.
I know. I love it.
Thanks a lot, Mayor Goodwin.
Thank you.
We'll be talking regatta over the next couple of days, of course, as it kicks off on Wednesday. Tomorrow on the show, Jared Page from the city of St. Albans, Brad McElhenney will be on the show too. Hoppy coming, or actually Dave Wilson in for Hoppy with Talk Line. See you tomorrow. Till then, have fun and love somebody.
96.5 FM Charleston and 104.5 Cross Lanes, a WVRC media station. We're proud.